Peering inside of a great covered barge, you can just get a quick look at the four big rocket engines at the base of the SLS rocket. It arrived at the Kennedy Space Center late yesterday. A barge is about the only thing big enough to hold it. On this rocket rest the hopes of the United States to send astronauts back to the moon. Those engines, which once powered the space shuttles, have been test-fired. The rocket is here for a test launch beyond the moon. It's a short trip from the barge to the mobile launch pad where the SLS will lift off. The pad is waiting for it right now, here in the Vehicle Assembly Building. On that platform already assembled are two booster rockets that will be attached to the sides of the new rocket. The boosters are another artifact of the space shuttle era. The test launch, the first liftoff of the Artemis Moon program, should be one of the biggest events to come along in quite some time. NASA's trying to keep it on track.
So we're still trying to hold the Artemis 1 uncrewed test flight of Orion and SLS this calendar year. That will be very challenging.
The NASA Inspector General, while reporting last week that the price tag for the moon effort will increase to $86 billion, said NASA's current plans to launch the SLS in 2021 and ultimately land astronauts on the moon by the end of 2024 is highly unlikely. But that won't keep the Kennedy Space Center workforce from trying, and now it's more than just computer animation and drawing board designs. They've got a real rocket to work on. At KSC, Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.
The big rocket will be unloaded from its barge early tomorrow morning and then rolled into the Vehicle Assembly Building to be prepared for launch.